إن الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونتوب إليه من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا ومعلمنا وقائدنا وشفيعنا محمد ابن عبد الله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه. أرسله الله رحمة للعالمين، فجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين، فبلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة، فمحى الله به الغمة، فاللهم اجزه عنا خير الجزاء. سيدي وحبيبي ونور قلبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. أما بعد، فيا أحباب رسول الله ويا أتباع رسول الله، أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله، فمن يتق الله يجعل له مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. إن خير الكلام كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I greet you with the greeting of Islam, the greeting of Ahlul Jannah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I've been witness there is no God worthy of worship except Allah, and I've been witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his final messenger. O you believe, fear Allah. Fear Allah and don't die except in the face of Iman. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warns us from every newly invented matter in the religion of Islam can take us in the wrong path, can end us in hellfire, wal-iyazu billah. Indeed, the best word is the word of Allah, and the best guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah ala ni'mat al-iman. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we don't thank Him enough. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He bestowed the iman in our heart and give us another chance to worship Him, another Friday, to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the guidance. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He gather us in Friday, today, to gather us, all of us, in the Firdaus al-A'la, say Ameen. Alhamdulillah ala ni'mat al-Iman. Allahumma laka alhamda hamd al-shakirin, hamd al-zakirin. اللهم لك الحمد حمدا دائما مباركا يليق بجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. أنت كما أثنيت على وجهك حر وجوهنا وجوه والدينا ووالد والدينا عن النار. الذنب كبير والعمل قليل، ولا نثق إلا في رحمته وهو أرحم الراحمين. Indeed, our good deed is not too much. But we believe and we trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mercy. And we will enter, inshaAllah, the paradise, not by our a'mal, but by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-umru mahdood. The age is limited. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in hadith akhrajahu al-Tirmizi, wa Abu Majah, an Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, الذي لا ينطق عن الهوى, the one who doesn't speak in his own mind, وإنما هو وحي يوحى, every word that come out of the mouth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a revelation. The best mankind, the best one who stepped in this earth, معلم البشرية, the teacher for every mankind, the one that if you graduate from his school, you are the winner. Al-Madrasa al-Muhammadiyya, the school of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best school. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in hadith, rawahu Abu Hurairah, said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a'mar ummati min bayna al-sittini wal-sab'een. The age of my ummah is gone between the 60 and the 70. وَلَا يَزِيدُ عَنْهَا إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ And the only one who will increase
is a little bit.
Some مضللين and some people who are not a believer, a strong believer, they said that this hadith is at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because he didn't have the medicine and the technology and the health benefits. But I answer them and I tell them, إِنَّ الْقُرْآنَ وَالْحَدِيثِ لِكُلِّ مَكَانٍ وَكُلِّ زَمَانٍ The Qur'an and the Hadith is for every place and every time for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَأَنَّهُ لَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى Doesn't speak from his own mind. If this Hadith is said, is my ummah in my time, then I can tell you yes. And also Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in the end of the time, ملك الموت he will يقبض أرواح the young people. The young age. الموت الفجأة and the sudden death. And also the young age it will be taken from our life. By the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we lived it. For the year past we lost loved ones. And in the beginning of the COVID, they said it's only affecting the elderly and the people who have a heart problem and the people who have diabetic, and we lost young people. As if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us a message clear in the past year to wake us up and shake us. And we were shaked and our iman raised up. But then we get the vaccine and then we get comfortable and we went back to our life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us so much. And He gave us another test. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves His ibad. And He wants us to teach us something. That our age and our time passing so much fast. You say, I came here to this country 30 years ago, 25 years ago, as if it's like yesterday. Then why? What do we need to know? We need to know what we earn and what we have and what we own. We own power. And we need to learn about this power today, in our khutbah today. تعرف على القوة. That Allah give it to you. Get to know the power that Allah gives you. Every single one of us. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على المصطفى المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليك يا سيدي يا حبيبي يا رسول الله صلاة وسلاما متلازمين كلما ذكرك الذاكرون وغفل عن ذكرك الغافلون 50 years ago a scientist guy from America went to South Africa searching for diamond. And at that time, they didn't have the equipment and the technology. Then the job was a little bit harder. And he searched for diamond. That's his job. And one day, coming back from work, a hard job, and failure after failure, cannot find diamond. He met a young man, a child, who's holding a big rock. And this science American guy, he said to him, can you show me what you have in your hand and can you give it to me? And this South African kid, he said to him, I'm not gonna give it to you until you give me something. Then this American guy, he put his hand in his pocket and he brought a chocolate, piece of chocolate, and give it to the kid. The kid was very happy. He gave him this piece of rock and he took the chocolate and he was so happy. And it's come to after that that this piece of rock it's the most biggest diamond in the whole world. And the child gave it for a piece of chocolate
for a sweet. You say you how full he is. But you know what? We do this every day. We do this in our life every day. We give the time for a piece of chocolate. We give our soul for the sweetness of the dunya. For the pleasure of what we don't have and what we want. Then what I want to say, don't give your soul for a piece of chocolate. And give up. Give up on the fear that you don't have what others have. Every one of us give our soul, which is the diamond, for a piece of chocolate because we are afraid that we don't have what he has. Because not everyone have is happy. I'm looking at you that you have the biggest house. And I believe if I get what you have, I'll be happy like you. Guess what? He doesn't sleep in the night. And he called me and he cried and he had depression. And he said, take everything what I have and give me a peace of mind. Saada, the happiness, is not what you earn from the dunya. It's what you have that Allah created you with. Allah created us all with a diamond in our heart, which is the soul. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala nafakha min ruhihi fi Adam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He created Adam, He make him and make us the Khalifa in the earth. We have all the potential to be happy. We created to be like that. By the power of Allah, قَبْضَةٌ مِن نُورِ اللَّهِ قَبْضَةٌ مِن نُورِ اللَّهِ. But we refuse and we give it away for a piece of chocolate. كُنْ عَبْدًا لِلَّهِ. Become a servant to Allah. عَبْدًا شَكُورًا وَلَا تَكُونَ عَبْدًا لِشَهْوَتِكَ. Be a servant to Allah and don't be a slave to your desire. إِذَا تَقَرَّبْتَ إِلَى اللَّهِ صَحَّ بَدَنُكَ وَعَقْلُكَ وَمَالُكَ وَاهْتَدَى عِيَالُكَ وَضَمَنْتَ الدُّنْيَا بِحِلْوَهَا وَمَا سُهَا. If you get closer to Allah and you become a servant to Allah, you'll be healthy in your body and your brain and your kids and your wealth. People complaining, I made all what I want, desire in this dunya, but I lost my kids. I turned around, I didn't see my wife. The divorce high, the rate of divorce last year is very high. The loss of the kids is very high. The depression is very high. But also the success is very high. But success in how? It's called fake hope. Al-amal al-wahmi. As if you feel that what your business and what your house and what you're driving is will bring you happiness. I am telling you in advance, the people who reach this goal, they right now, they wish they don't have it, and they want the peace of mind. And the peace of mind comes, mahabbatillah, the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I will not make it longer, but I will make you live a day with Umm al-Mu'mineen Aisha, the mother of the believer Aisha. When the Sahaba came to Aisha and they told her, Ya Umm al-Mu'mineen, tell us a story about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Tell us ajab, something that we get impressed by. And she said, in the life of the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all of it ajab, all of us are impressing. But one day was special. This one day, she was impressed by that day and was ajab that day. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to Aisha in her night, and Aisha was so happy by the presence of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she cannot wait to her love, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to come to the bed. And when he came, he said to her, Ya Aisha, let me with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want to have khulwa. I want to be with Allah that night. And she said to him, Ya Rasulullah, inni uhibbuk wa uhibbu guwarik. Oh Ya Rasulullah, I love you and I love to be beside you. And he said to her, let me to go to your Rabb. Let me be with Allah. And she said, he stand up and he went and make wudu. وَلَمْ يُكْثِرُ فِي الْمَاءِ And he didn't make too much wudu with too much water.
In our masjid here, go after one brother, you need a swimsuit because you're going to swim in the water. It's a swimming pool, it's not a bathroom. Wallahi, I see it every Friday.
But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best mankind who stepped in this earth, and this is not our topic, but our topic is that Aisha said, he came out of the bath and he make wudu and he didn't use too much water. Listen to the details. And then he prayed. And he stand up and pray. Until his beard becomes so wet, soaking wet from crying. And then he went in sujood. And she said the ground was so wet from his sujood. And then she said after he finished the sujood, he kept praying and crying. And then he sit down and he kept crying and praying. From Qiyam al-Layl, until Bilal came to wake him up for Salat al-Fajr. And when Bilal came to him and looked at him and he looked at his condition, the ground is wet, his face was wet, his beard was wet, his eyes was red. Then Bilal said to him, Ya Rasulullah, atabki, you pray, you cry. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ghafara laka ma taqaddam wa ma ta'akhkhar. And Allah forgive your sin from the past and the coming. And he said to him, Ya Bilal, first, ala akuna abdan shakura. I cannot be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that reward. And second, Ya Bilal, laqad unzila alayya hadhihi al-layla Qur'an. O Bilal, that was revealed by Gabriel tonight. Quran, the last 10 ayat from Al Imran. Inna fi khalq al-samawati wal-ard wa ikhtilaf al-layl wal-nahar al-ayat li-uli al-albab. Ya Bilal, anyone who read this and he don't think about this ayat, he will lose bi Rabbil Kaaba. He will be a failure and he will lose in this dunya. O Bilal, in this last 10 ayat, he stayed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam crying for the whole ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that they will remind themselves that they are memorizing Quran but they don't understand the meaning of the Quran. Ya ikhwan, falnahya al-Quran. We live the Quran, we understand the Quran, we translate the Quran, we practice the Quran. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kana Qur'anun yamshi baynana. The Quran is not only to enjoy recitation and we say Allah, but to live it and to understand the purpose behind it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the last 10 ayat from Ala Umran, whoever read it and don't understand the meaning, he would be a failure in this dunya. Because the day and night, اختلاف الليل والنهار والأرض والسماوات, all this for a purpose that you work and you understand the day of judgment and you will be judged. Then live, but live for the better life. All of us in these days, we complaining. Should we say Happy New Year? Should we say Merry Christmas? We are all of us, every year we go to this life. I'm talking about time, ya ikhwan. I'm talking about, I'm getting closer to my qabr. I'm saying that the time, the clock is ticking. Sajda fi gawf al-layli wal-nas niyam khayrun min ad-dunya wa rabbul Kaaba. Two rak'ahs in the darkness, in the night, when everybody's sleeping and nobody watch you. Better that I stay here in the masjid and show everybody my muscle how I'm praying. القرب إلى الله هو النجاة في هذه الدنيا. Get closer to Allah, you will survive. People dying right and left, age, divorce, depression, losing kids, losing loved ones. It didn't tell you anything. It didn't tell you anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you are next. This ayat, go tonight and open Surah Al-Imran, the last 10 ayat, and recite it and understand the meaning of it. And see, what's mean new resolution or the resolution? Everybody want to be healthier, stronger, richer, kids obey him. All this can happen when you get closer to Allah. Did you ask yourself why you're not happy and why your kids is not obeying you, obedient, and why your wife is not obedient? It's because you're far away from Allah. احسن الوقوف امام الله. Be good in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everybody around you and behind you will straight up. When you straight up. When to احسن الوضوء, from the minute that you enter the wudu and the minute you're using the water to the minute that you're standing in front of Allah, the minute you're raising your hand and you know that Allah will give you, the minute that you don't ask Allah because you know that Allah is the best giver, the minute that you trust in the hand of Allah is not in your hand, the minute that you raise your kids and your wife that depend on Allah and not on you, you are a believer. When these beautiful young kids depend all their life upon their father and the mother, you are the worst raiser for family. Because you already raised them to fail in this dunya because you're not going to be around. The only way to raise the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when our kids and our wife knows that the one who give the risk is Allah. When your kids run to Allah and not to run to you. When the kids want something and go to Allah and ask him before you. This is where you find the happiness. When you find that you and your kids are running to pray. When you compete to make siyam. When you compete to serve the masjid. When you compete in each other. Who will recite more and who will memorize more? لا خير في أمة القرآن ليس شعارها. There is no blessing in the ummah that the Quran is not the guiding for it. And this year I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather an ummah on one khalifa, the one who remind the ummah that not America and not anywhere in the world will be the savior. The savior is Allah. And not the vaccine will protect our kids, but the hafiz is Allah. And not the money in the bank is our secure ticket. The secure ticket is a qara'tum al-Quran. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say to Bilal, Ya Bilal, arihna biha. O Bilal, comfort our heart with the salah. When the salah becomes the love to your heart, you are the winner. إني داعي فأمنوا. اللهم اهدنا في من هدي وعافنا في من عافي وتولنا في من تولي وبارك الله لنا فيما أعطيت. اللهم اصرف عنا شر ما قضيت. اللهم اهدنا واهدي بنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم احفظنا يا كريم. اللهم احفظ أولادنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم احفظنا يا كريم. اللهم فقهنا في القرآن. اللهم إنا نسألك الخير كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. اللهم إنا نسألك بكل ما سأل به عبد ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك بكل ما استعاذ به نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم إنا نسألك الفردوس الأعلى وكل ما يقرب إليها من قول أو عمل. اللهم لا تفتنا في ديننا. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكثر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا للنار مصيرنا. اللهم اشفنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اشفنا يا كريم. اللهم اجعل القرآن ربيع
قلوبنا اللهم فقهنا في القرآن اللهم اجعله حجة لنا لا حجة علينا اللهم احينا على الإسلام وأمتنا على الإسلام وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.